You're
gonna sign here, so please.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is it in?
Thank you. got one. This one for you, man.
Which one is it? Did you get the two? Are you open to sell one, baby? You gotta do the thing with that one? Yeah. All right, it's $20, but you know you know $20. Same thing is.
Thank you. I get the Senate. I want to go to the Senate. Go out and do that. What's up to you?
She's on a little bank credit. Going on, running.
Praise the Lord. give us the choice, you have got to give respect to whom respect is due, to be our last respect, to be our mother. We love and find new leadership from the family members. May you sit.
Good morning. My name is Lister Ordain, the niece of Steve Charles, getting ready to read the eulogy. Steve Charles, who was better known as Leppo, he was born on June 28, 1947. He was the sixth child of Bermuda Charles Daniel and Cyril Finley. Steve grew up in the hills of Lavington and attended a scholar EC school. He worked in Port Authority for several years before retirement. He fathered 8 children, Anthony, Nicole, Nigel, who is deceased, Pat, Pamela, Jason, Shayna, and Benjamin. Steve was also known for his slang years. Oh my, I ain't hear you, I show you. He loved to enjoy himself, and during Christmas time, when he was young, him and the guys in his neighborhood dressed in the same shirt and pants and went from house to house parading. He also loved his jewelry in the famous Rico Desperado Steel Orchestra. Steve will truly be missed by his family and his friends. Rest in eternal peace and say hello to all the loved ones he loved and lost till we meet again.
May you rise. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead. The first is of all who have come last night. Brother, through this mystery, your servants speak. Your servants speak Charles, who has gone to his resting place, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, our Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. One God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us sit for the beginning.
This reading is from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 4, verse 7 through 15. Untarnished life. This is ripe old age. The virtuous man, though he die before his time, will rest. Length of days is not what makes age honorable, nor numbers of years the true measure of life. Understand, this is man's greatest gift. Untarnished life. This is ripe old age. He has sought to please God, so God has loved him. As he was living among sinners, he has been taken up. He has carried out so that evil men have walked his understanding or treasure seduce his soul. For the fascination of evil throws good things into the shade, and the whirlwind of desires corrupts a sinful heart. Coming to perfection in so such a while, he achieved long life. His soul being peace into the Lord, he has taken him quickly from the wickedness around him. Yet people look on, uncomprehending, it does not enter their heads. that grace and mercy awaits the chosen of the Lord and protection of his holy ones. This is the word of the Lord.
St. John. Mother said to Jesus, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you. Your mother said Jesus will have the rise again. Mother said that Lord will rise again at the resurrection of the last day. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she said, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world. The gospel of the Lord, praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us see. Dear friends and brothers, we have come to pay our last respect to our brother St. Charles and to console the bereaved family. And to console the bereaved family. The wife, which is here, the children, the relations, the members of this community, friends and relatives who have come from different parts of the country and are here today to pay their last respect to him. He is one of us, and we cannot abandon him. Even in that, in the creed of the Catholic Church, we profess, I believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. I believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of the saints, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. That is our creed. And St. Paul says, whether we are alive or dead, we belong to Christ. So not even death can separate us from the love of Christ. Not even affliction, not even peril, not even hunger. There is nothing that can separate us from the Lord Jesus Christ. My brother Jesus Charles believed in Christ and he communed with Christ during his sojourn on earth. And now he has finished his race. He has gone to his Maker and is telling us that what you are, I have been. And where I am today, you will join. He is not the first person to die, he will be the last. Death is something all of us anticipate, and it comes at a time we do not know. Shakespeare says, and death, the necessary end, will come when it will come. The mystery surrounding death is that we do not know when, how, and where. We do not know when we shall die. We do not know where we shall die. We do not even know how we are going to die. But the truth is that all of us will die sometime, someday. And if it is true that we will live in this world forever, how do we prepare for our homecoming? How do we prepare for our homecoming? Are we going to live anyhow and die anyhow without preparing? If some people die just like that and never prepare for their homecoming, it is not very good. We need to prepare for certain things in life. If our brother St. Charles, if he weren't in the funeral homes to do some work, and they didn't prepare him on time. He wouldn't have been here on time. They wouldn't have brought him here on time to make sure that he gets to the church before 9:30. They have to start preparing the body on time. You prepare yourself for work. You don't just go to work anyhow or arrive any time you want. You prepare for work. You prepare to go to the church. You prepare for everything you are doing. If you are traveling, if you're traveling outside the country and you need to board a flight, you need to prepare for it. If you don't prepare, you will miss your flight. Experience has taught us that you need to be here at least 1 hour to the time. Some are here 2 hours to the time. Some are even there 3 hours to the time. But you need to be here. If you start preparing 30 minutes to the time, you will miss the flight. They will tell you, no, you can't meet up. You can't. And you know the consequences. You have to pay extra fee and all of that. The point is that you've missed it. And if it is something that is very expedient to you that you have to do, you will miss that. So, what I'm saying to you is that we prepare for everything in life. A woman that is going to give birth prepares for, the expectant woman prepares for the child she is anticipating to give birth to. She won't just live in her house in order to give birth at the ninth month. It doesn't happen that way. She has to refrain for 7 days. The doctor will tell her, you don't take alcoholic drink, you don't do this, you don't do that. When you are waiting to the time, you still hold and all of that in preparation. If she's not well fed, she needs blood, she needs to eat this type of food so that you won't run short of blood. All of that are tilted towards preparation. A student that wants to pass examination will be on time to prepare for examination, otherwise the student will fail for lack of preparation. Difference in Christ. The question now is, how am I preparing for my homecoming? How do I prepare? If it is certain that one day I will meet this world, am I in spirit going to take me unawares? Let us be eating, drinking, partying, clubbing, doing lots of things, and eventually die. Is that the type of death I want to die? How do I prepare now that I have the time? When somebody dies and all of us come to church, it is also a moment of sober reflection. It is a time to ask ourselves certain questions regarding our lives, regarding the way we live our lives. Prepare for your homecoming. You do not know when the master will come. Whether he comes in the morning, he comes in the afternoon, he comes in the evening, he comes in the night. Be ready and be like the five virgins that kept their lamps lit. Let it not be that when the master comes, you look at your lantern and you find out that there is no oil in the pan, and you want to go and get oil. It is late. It's not a great thing that you do at the nick of time. We can't come back to come amend, to amend our lives. These are some of the implications of going to look for extra oil in order to keep our lantern burning. It's like making a reversal. Give me time, let me come back and change my life. Give me time, let me come back and live a good life. Give me time. Let me come back and start living a truthful life. Give me time. Let me come back and twist my step and refrain from evil and start living a good life. Give me time so that I live as a child of light, not as a child of darkness. Give me time. Let me begin to do the right thing. But it is late. You can't go back again. You can go back once the call, once you are called, you are called. You can go back. It will be late. If our brother was waiting for the time, the 100 years before he starts living a good life, you see, he wouldn't have, it would have taken him hours. Something would give themselves time. Instead of the time when he come, I turn 90, then I start coming to church. The time I turn 95, I start living a good life. How do you know you get to 90 or 95? This is the time. This is the sacred time. This is the time of salvation. This is the sacred time. This is the time you give your life completely to Christ. This is the time you begin to live a good life. This is the time to take your prayer life seriously. So that you don't have time to regret. Because we will not come back to increase our steps, that would be too late. That would be too late. A student was in examination hall and his pen was no longer writing. And he went to the point to run a mathematical state and so on. And he was writing mathematics. To compound a problem, he gave it the pen that is almost finished. And then he ran, when his pen finished, he stood up, he wanted to collect pen from another student. Then he said, no, I can't do that. Sit down. He said, I don't have room. Sit down. I don't have mathematical stuff. I want to borrow from who cannot borrow. Sit down and do your work. That would amount to examination mathematics. And this student is supposed to walk independently. So all this while he was directing the primary exams, house exams, he informed me that he should come with all his written materials and walk independently. And the dissertation hall he wanted to follow. Even his pen disappointed me. And he couldn't do any other thing. And that was when I felt the cost. So the difference in Christ that we should today is that we need to prepare for our own coming. Let it be that if Jesus calls me now, I am ready. I want to look back. He said, I'm ready. Your servant is ready. Because we can't even say, Lord, we cannot save him. The other time I went to the hospital to anoint a baby. The baby was barely 2 weeks old. 2 weeks old. And before you knew what was happening, the baby died. The father was there, the mother was there. And the priest was there. He prayed the spirit of holy water, committing her soul into the hand of God. And they wrapped the baby a white cloth. And when you look at that child, it's like the baby sleeping. But the doctor has confirmed the baby dead. Only 2 weeks. And I started asking myself, this person, this boy was born alive, he cried. But after some time, he started developing some complications. He was in the hospital for 2 weeks. And at the end of the day, the child still gave up. Listen, and some of us have spent more than 40 years. And this boy, this baby spent only 2 weeks in this world and returned to the slave. So, it doesn't matter. It comes to anybody. Even a child in the womb dies. A child in the womb can die.
Back in the mountain, Peter says, as soon as a man is born into the world, he's old enough to die.
As soon as a man is born into the world, he is old enough to die. So, death does not mean death. It's not a respecter of any person. It can come to anybody, irrespective of your age, irrespective of who you are. But the point is that let it be that we are prepared. When the parents were crying, the mother was crying, Adam was the day, they said, no, 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 you don't need to do that. You don't need to cry so much. If you want that in the world, all of us expect to live up to 100 years and so on, enjoy life, get married and all of that. But I think that it is a better time to die. The child has committed no sin. It is so the same as that. How he came is how he's going. You don't think of health of him, you don't think of poverty of him. He received baptism. You think he removed sweat to his neck. It's all. The letter says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. The child is pure in heart. The child is innocent. So be happy that you have a saint in heaven. The gospel reading today, and even the first reading taken from the book of wisdom, is telling us that it is, he said, the virtuous man, though he died before his time, will find rest. Length of days is not what makes age honorable. Nor number of years the true measure of life. Understanding, this is man's gray hairs. Unpunished life, this is ripe old age. Unpunished life, untempered life, a pure life. If we live a pure life, if we live a unpunished life, we have already attained old age in the sight of God. So if it's not length of days that makes you have honorable, we're going to celebrate old people, elderly people, said celebration of life. We meet 100 years, 100, 10 years, 120. But if a person is living a bad life, it becomes a contradiction. It becomes a contradiction. And the gospel reading of this way, mother said to Jesus, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you. Martha was a sister to Mary and their brother Lazarus, a family of three children. When Lazarus was ill, they sent for Jesus. Having heard that Jesus is a wonder worker, if Jesus touches Lazarus, Lazarus will die. And Jesus came after 4 days. Before that time, Lazarus is dead and buried. And when they saw Jesus coming, but Jesus told the disciples, let us go and wake our brother Lazarus up, for he is asleep. And while he was on his way, they ran after him and hugged him. Even started crying, if you were here, my brother wouldn't have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, God will do it for you. And Jesus was telling him that I am the resurrection, I am the life. If you believe in me, even if you die, you shall live. Do you believe that? Mother said, yes, I know that my brother will rise again at the resurrection of the last day. But Jesus was saying, you are meeting life face to face. It doesn't matter how many days your brother is in the tomb. Believe that your brother is alive. And that statement that Jesus said is not something to be interpreted from a federal, material
perspective, something that transcends the spiritual temporal realm, is something the Buddha says, to whom shall we go to have the message of eternal life? So that statement is a message of eternal life, that those who believe in Christ, even if they die, they shall live, they will live in eternity. It doesn't matter whether they are dead or whether they are buried. It doesn't matter. If you believe in Christ and you die, you will live. You won't die the second death. The physical death is for everybody. There is a second one. And the second one is the one we should be afraid of. That is it. Your brother will live. And in order to tell them that what he's saying was true, you see, open the grave. He said, no, if you think that you'll be stinking, it's almost all this man has been there. He said, remove the stones. And they did that with Jesus' words. That was the shortest verse in the Bible, Jesus' words. And he shouted and prayed to God. He said, Lazarus, come out. Lazarus came out alive. So Jesus was telling us that he is the resurrection, he is the life. If you believe in me, even if you die, you shall live. Our brother Charles believed in Christ. Now that he is dead, he is alive in Christ. Is alive, but living in another form of life. And those where look with vivid shine is something they call form of life. In that form of life, we is alive in the spiritual world, not in the material realm. In the material realm, all of us are alive. Then in the spiritual realm, he is alive because his soul is at peace with God. Let us console ourselves with this words, that our brother Steve Charles is in the hand of God. No evil will torment him. We pray that God will forgive whatever faults they must have committed to him and frailty, and grant his soul eternal rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let me rise for the prayer of the faithful. We pray that our brother Charles may be with God in eternity, and that God is going to say, and forgive whatever sins he has committed to human frailty. Lord, hear us. For our brother St. Charles, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may not be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us. For brothers and Charles who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, Lord, hear us. For brothers and Charles who proclaimed the good news of Jesus Christ and suffered the needs of the poor, that he may be welcomed to the sanctuary of heaven, Lord, hear us. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us. And for those who have come yesterday with the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, hear us. We pray for the mourners, for the family and friends of our brother, St. Charles, that they may be consumed in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. For all of us who have assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. May you add a private petition in the name soon of our brothers of Charles and Telegram of God. God, our shelter and our strength, listen in God to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers of offer for the departed brothers of Charles, cleansing of the sins, and granting the fullness of redemption. We ask this in faith through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us sit. It is a time for offertory collection. Thank you. May we rise, please. Pray, brethren, that your sacrifice of mine and your sacrifice of God, the Father Almighty, may the Lord accept the sacrifice of the hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church. As we humbly present to you this sacrificial offering, so Lord, for the salvation of your servants, your child, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not bow to your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God, which is right and just. It is we want to choose our duty and our salvation of his and everywhere to give a thanks for the Father, Mother, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Within the hope of the blessed resurrection has gone, but through suffering by the certainty of dying, might be consumed by the promise of immortality to come. And be for your faithful Lord, life is changed not in death, and when this any dwelling comes to God's, and eternal dwellings to pray for them in heaven. The sweet angels and archangels, the kings and the dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as we bow today. We are glad. The mystery of faith. Thank you. We become a ministry speaker of the Holy Spirit for the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our brother, Jason, our bishop, Norrie, we give all our brothers and sisters who come as name in hope of resurrection. And all who apply your mercy, welcome them into the light of your peace. Have this on us, for we pray. That we bless you to be the one of God, bless you to save his approaching spouse, and bless the apostles, and all the saints of praise you throughout the ages. We may merit to behold his eternal life, and the grace of your power through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through you, our team, and me, O Lord Almighty Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, and God of His earth, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, performed by the divine teaching, we are to sing, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us also be free from every evil, which is in our lives, that by the help of your mercy, those who conceive and sin from all distress, as we go to bless the poor and come of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God's land forever. Lord Jesus Christ, is with your apostles, peace I give him and peace I give you. Live not as in the faith of your church, and which is the ground of his written apostles of the way, who live and pray for ever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. May we bow to each other as a sign of peace. Thank you. we await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our antropologies to conform with his glorified power. Let us pray, let us stand. Grant we pray, Almighty God, that your servant, to Charles, who today has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the blessed joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brothers and Charles and our fellow express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys within death itself. The choir should sing.
In your sight, may he be forever.
forgive whatever sins he committed to human goodness, and your goodness grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We gather here to commend our brothers and sisters to God our Father and to commit his body to eat in the spirit of faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Let us raise our voice in song and offer our prayers as we chant. Because God has chosen to call our brothers and sisters from this life to himself, we commit his body to the faith. For we are God's, and unto God's, we shall return. That the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be in thy peace and glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brothers and sisters to the Lord, that the Lord will bless him in peace and resurrect his body on the last day. Let us pray. Will you bow your face and pray for God's blessings? And will you please sign the book for the happy days of our blessed child? Blessed the Lord, you look happy for the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your prayer, hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We can always grant unto him, O Lord, and let the ritual of come upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May his soul and his souls are kept in the party, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of the Son of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console us, and gently light every tear from our eyes, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs sing Charles. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the powers of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And here as long as his call no longer, may you find eternal place. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Oh, Yes, come, come, come.
Thank you.
is the desolation of his
box.
Yeah, how to be the box?
Man has fall, man has fall.
Did he hold it?
Huh?
Did he hold it?
Mm-hmm.
Is it?
Well, basically, you only had this spot here. It's only this spot around here.
Yeah.
Because normally it's going in back now. Yeah, shut up for me and I'll see this here.
I didn't want him in the back.
In the back?
I know. So that's why I organized again. Nice. I'm a mom. supposed to be here. Yeah, but yeah, because we were quite, old and I'm not here.
Cheers.
Let's go. Step aside. The name is yet?
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Spirit. Amen. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us, preserve us from the fire of hell. Take all souls to heaven and help especially those most in need. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters, and restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. God, thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Oh, praise the holy people, praise the holy nation, for his merciful kindness is great towards us. And the truth of the Lord endures forever. My brother, take your rest.
In peace.
In peace. I hope you had sufficient time to talk to your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I know if you repent, my son, you will be in the arms of Jehovah God this evening. And this evening, you leave a lot of us to grieve. But we will grieve only for a time. Only for a time, my dear brother. So take it easy and rest in peace.
Peace.
Rest in peace.
Guide me, O thou great Redeemer, bring me to this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty.
I am weak, but thou art mighty.
Hold me, Lord, in your powerful hand.
Hold me, Lord, in your powerful hand.
Bread of life, bread of heaven.
I want some more.
My God and my Redeemer this evening. Father God, I am pleased with what you has done. My brother has gone from work unto reward. And if you know you've gone from work unto reward, you had sufficient time to ask God to have mercy upon you this evening. He said, mercy I ask, mercy to God. This is my humble prayer to you. You say, can a woman tender tears cease the words that changes you? Yet she may forget from thee. Then, O Lord, remember me, O Lord. Oh, remember me. So seek and you shall.
Knock.
Open your heart.
Hello.
My God.
Hello.
My brother.
Hello.
Peace. Love. Rest.
My God.
Pain and rest.
My God. My God.
Take care.
My God. Three brothers I have all gone.
Oh yeah.
Only have two sisters alive now. Mm. Asking God for faith and courage.
Lover of my soul.
I have my nieces.
What?
And my nephew. I thank God for the great and wonderful things he has done for you. And I thank him that I was here to see.
In the air and waters
roll. Feed me today. Once more.
Open up the crystal fountain.
Open down. All you must learn him. Learn him. When the healing streams above, songs of praises, songs of praises, lead me straight on Canaan shore. Songs of praises. Songs of praises.
Walking in front of one. Walking through. Walking in the path in this world.
When I tread the vault of Jordan, I tread the vault of God. When my spirit is subside, when my spirit is. He says, songs of praises.
Songs of praises,
lead you straight on Canaan shore,
lead you straight on Canaan shore.
Amen.
Amen.
All the changing scenes of life, problems are endured. Praise the my God, the Spirit within my heart, my God.
Father, I stretch
my hands today.
My hands today. No other hand I know. If thou wilt draw thyself from me. Oh, where shall I go? You're gone from sin to set you free. You're gone to meet your Jehovah God. And may God take you into the arms of his bosom today. My dear brother, rest in peace and take your flight unto Jehovah God. He's waiting for you. He is waiting for you, brother. He is waiting for you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Take your flight. Jesus is waiting there for you. And rest in peace. We will meet on that beautiful shore. We will meet over yonder. And when we meet, we will sing hallelujah to the King, man. Hallelujah to the King. The God, the bad, and the preferred have to go down in that dirt. You have money, you have house, you have car, you have everything. But one thing God make,
God, we have to go down to earth. And dust to dust, and say ashes to ashes. Praise and thank be to God. Hello. Mm-hmm. Hello, you. Mm-hmm. Hello, you, Master. Mm-hmm. Hello.
Bah.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Bah.
Ashe. Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, praise
the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Be well.
Go in peace.
Go in peace in your chamber.
Go in peace. God is good.
He's wonderful.
All the time.
All the time.
For his mercy and joy forever. No more sorrow.
No more pain.
No more weeping.
Uh-huh.
And no more pain.
Oh,
you
God.
Had enough. And your father say you had enough.
It's
and
enough.
He take you home to dwell with him in paradise. Yes. I hope you make your pathway straight.
Mm-hmm.
Because you had a long time.
Make your bed smooth.
Rain coming. Come on.
Yeah.
Goodbye,
world.
I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, man of sin. I stay no longer with you. May you have my mind to hold on with the rest of my life. I may have my mind to hold on with the rest of my life. Goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. By pleasure of sin, I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go back to the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go back to the rest of my life.
I need thy friend.
Oh. Yeah. my brother tonight on along the road. Where is my brother tonight on along the road? And look, he gone with his little wife on along the road. And look, he gone with his little wife on along the road. Where is that boat tonight? On along the road, where is the brother today? On along the road, I look he gone, and he look he gone along the road. Oh, look he gone along the road.
Praise God.
Lie down, fill a burden. Lie down and take your rest. Lay down your head upon my Savior's breast. We love you, dear, but Jesus loved you best. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Lie down, beloved. Lie down and take your rest. Lay down your head upon thy Savior's breast. We love you, dear, but Jesus loves you best. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.